Many people who have never tried LSD are very curious what the experience feels like, but they don't necessarily want to try the drug themselves. Unfortunately, or fortunately, this is just one of those things where you need personal experience to truly understand what it's like. It's kind of like trying to explain to someone what being in love feels like. No amount of explanation is going to do the chemical cocktail called in love justice. No, I'm not comparing an LSD trip to being in love. What I am simply saying is that without reference experience, you have nothing to compare my descriptions to. It's kind of like explaining to you the color red. The only way that you're gonna understand what red looks like is if you've seen red before. First of all, I am not making this video to either encourage or discourage anyone from trying LSD. The only humans who should try acid are ones that can properly weigh the risks and the benefits. I have personally tried LSD several times in the past. However, this is not something that I've ever needed to do at a consistent rate, nor is it something that I'm currently doing. I see psychedelics as tools, and you only need a tool when you've got something to fix, or you have a purpose for that tool. LSD doesn't work like other drugs. LSD works in conjunction with how you currently feel and your surroundings to create the experience. For example, if you were to, say, do a line of coke, probably doesn't matter where you are, it's gonna give you that nice rush and that euphoric feeling. Versus when you take LSD, what it kinda does is it takes into consideration who you are as a person, where you currently are in your life, your immediate surroundings, and all of that goes into what the experience is going to be like for you at that certain time. So if you took LSD on two different occasions where you were in two separate moods, it could be two totally different experiences with two very different effects. What I'm getting at is LSD is kind of like a grab bag. You never know what you're gonna get. This will not be an exhaustive list. If you want a full list of the effects of LSD, I have included several links in the video description. What this video is going to be is a telling of my own personal subjective effects. What I'm going to do is list in a very linear way the effects of my experience, but you need to keep in mind that when you're undergoing one of these experiences, they don't usually follow the same continuity. So sometimes effects that I may list after other ones will happen before them. But just for the sake of this video, since we do live in a very linear universe, at least we perceive it that way, I need to list these effects in a linear way. Part 1, the physical effects. In about 50% of my experiences with LSD, one of the very first warning signs I have that the molecule is kicking in is it makes me feel like I've got to take a huge shit. It's kind of like my body recognizes that I'm about to be blasted clear out of this reality, and it says you better just release all the bowels so that you don't shit yourself out of pure amazement for what you're about to experience. Usually right after I shit, the effects start to slowly creep in. The first thing I will normally notice is my skin. It starts feeling a lot more sensitive. And after my skin feels sensitive, I start getting these sensations inside my body. A lot of people call this nausea, and I do get nausea, but it feels more like I can feel the internal processes going on. It's like you're experiencing your body as if you were just a newborn, fresh on this earth. Next, I usually get bursts of energy. I am notorious for pacing around in circles or just back and forth. Once the pacing has begun, that is when the visual effects will usually start to manifest. Part 2, the visual effects. The first effect I get is my visual acuity greatly enhances. Every time I'm looking at a sharp corner, everything looks a lot more crisp. Colors look a lot brighter, reds look redder, greens look greener. Lights can become unbearable to look at. For example, this blinding light on top of my camera. The second visual effect I get is what I like to call HD vision. It's as if all of a sudden everything I'm looking at has just widened and stretched out. It's like all of a sudden I can see a lot more clearly out of my peripheral vision. It's like I've been upgraded from, say, an old 640 by 480 CRT TV to full 1080p HD. And third, the edges of surfaces start looking very pastel and smudged. Everything in my visual field starts to come alive. Things like wood grain or even carpets or cracks and crevices, they all gain motion. It's a very flowy looking motion that they gain. Everything kind of moves fluidly as if it's a river. But this only occurs at a distance. If I really start getting up close to the objects I'm looking at, it's almost like the illusion halts and it stops flowing, proving to me that it is in fact an illusion and things really aren't moving. It's just my eyesight is kind of distorting the way that I'm perceiving shadows. It's all around the same time that morphing begins to happen. It's kind of like if I'm looking at an object, it will do this squash and stretch thing, as if everyone's staring out of a funhouse mirror. So if I'm looking at my head in the mirror, it'll look like it's stretching and shrinking and stretching and shrinking. It's also around this time that the auditory distortions are starting to kick in. What can happen is everything can get a little more echoey sounding, or on a higher dose, things like heavily layered music such as Spangl can sound absolutely euphoric. It's almost like you have this superpower where you can pick out any one layer to the song and you can dissect it and fully listen to that layer outside of the rest of the music. Fourth, this is when my pattern recognition capabilities reach their maxed out stats. It's almost like every surface I choose to give my attention to will have a varying degree of complex geometric patterns that are constantly shifting and crawling over top of the surfaces. And fifth, this is when I start getting tracers. A lot of people get tracers, also called trails, a lot earlier in their trips than I do. For some reason, this effect, which seems to occur for everyone else, rarely ever happens to me. That's like a ghosting effect. Like, say I wave my hand like this. Sixth, this stage is colored by fully immersive, three-dimensional rotating geometry. It's like I might be standing here, and all of a sudden I will see this geometric building construct right before my eyes, and I could just walk around it and look at it in 360 degrees as if I'm actually seeing a real object right in front of my visual field. It's during this stage that human faces take on an entirely new appearance. Everyone looks like a transparent, ghosting, mechanical entity made entirely of illusionary fabric, where words would never suffice in fully articulating just how visually phenomenal this looks. It is extremely easy in these states to be convinced that everything is Maya, that every aspect of our universe is a recreational dance, flowing in its own rhythm of immaculate beauty. Seventh, total blackout. The actual visual stimuli that I'm receiving at this stage can become so overwhelmingly intense that I will just pass out. I'll be out cold. It'll look like to everybody that I'm no longer conscious. Sometimes before passing out, I will appear to be fully functional and awake, but it's almost as if I'm in two places at the same time. It's kind of like in this frame, I'm in the room, but in the frame over here, I'm in a completely different place. But since you're watching the video, you can perceive both places at once visually. This is the exact same thing that is happening during the trip. I'm in two places at once. But I wouldn't necessarily say it's a visual thing as much as it's a mental thing. And with this, I will lead into the mental effects of an LSD trip. Part 3, the mental effects. Now, I will do my very best to try to correlate the mental effects to the visual effects. But again, keep in mind that just because I'm saying they happen around specific times doesn't necessarily mean that it always happens in that way. First, as everything begins to get brighter, my mind begins to slowly expand. Thoughts begin to speed up, and as this intensifies, it can feel as though everything is happening in slow motion. Basically, the faster you can think, the more thoughts that you can make it through in a shorter period of time. So what may have only been 10 minutes to everyone else feels like it's been 30 or 40 minutes to you, because you've had something like 30 minutes worth of thoughts in the time that you used to only have 10 minutes worth of thoughts. Does this logically make sense? Probably not, but that's what it feels like. This thought acceleration appears to have no limits, which can be a very scary thing when you enter the realm of bad trips. Time can completely lose meaning. And when time loses meaning to you, you can't just say to yourself, hey, I took a drug. This is gonna be over soon. Relax, sit on the couch. Throw on some good tunes, watch a movie, walk around in more circles. You can't do any of this, because as far as you are concerned, you are infinitely trapped in this perceived hell. Second, as my thoughts accelerate, they begin to feel as though they are not my own. This is experienced as my sense of self beginning to dissolve. This dissolution of the ego can become so intense that, like I already said, I can forget the linear motion of time. I will entirely forget that events happen one after the other, and instead I will perceive all of existence as this continuous cycle. This is a cycle where the center or beginning and end are always experienced simultaneously. In the same way that if you put your finger down on a two-dimensional circle, that point becomes both the starting point and the ending point all at the same time. But it doesn't matter which point you put your finger down on the circle, because no matter where you choose, it's the beginning and the end. Because no matter where I am physically or even mentally, I am always at the starting point, or the ending point, to each and every moment. During this experience, it can become increasingly easy to get trapped in those thought loops. This is usually accompanied by deja vu, and I will just keep cycling through the same thoughts or the same ideas or the same motions over and over and over again. I'll forget that I thought it, and then I'll think it again. It's like I'm just stuck playing this one snippet of audio, and whoever was controlling the computer at the time forgot that they left it on repeat. But each time it plays again, I feel like I'm listening to a new song. But I have this faint deja vu feeling that I already had this thought. It's as if each time it plays, it's like I'm listening to a totally new song. But I have this faint deja vu feeling that I already had that thought. This isn't necessarily a bad thing. Sometimes this can be very enlightening. It can give you the opportunity to really hammer home some new philosophies and new perspectives on the universe. But in the same regard, this can be a very terrifying thing, and a lot of people will usually call an ambulance at this point because they truly believe that they have lost their minds. And for all intents and purposes, they pretty much have lost their minds. I'm not going to sugarcoat this. Once you can't remember what you last thought, I think that could be seen as a definition of losing your mind, or at the very least, you've lost your ability to have a short-term memory. Third, the beginning of the communication between my conscious mind and my subconscious mind will begin. This often feels as though I'm communicating with an otherworldly entity. It can full-on feel like I'm talking to aliens. It's during this experience that my ego will really start to dissolve. This is usually when I'll start getting full-blown ego death. This effect usually happens about 2 or 3 hours into an experience. It happens around the same time that I'm getting the tracers, or it can even happen when I'm starting to see the overlaying patterns on top of everything. It's during this experience that I will usually learn some new grandiose information about my universe. I'll have a full-blown epiphany, and at times I can enter a full Satori state, which can feel like I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be right now in my life, that everything that has ever happened to me has happened for a reason, and that reason was to bring me to this exact moment, and this exact moment is the reason why I'm alive, and I'm alive to experience this exact moment, and now I'm going to get out of this, and I'm never going to be the same person again. And then 3 days later, as this enlightened being, I've just killed 10 hours of time playing Pokemon Omega Ruby. Now, during these enlightened Satori-like states, it can feel as though the entire universe is a living entity, and it's not only alive, but it loves me, and it loves me because it is me. I am the universe looking back at itself. We've all heard these terms before, at least many of us, but it's not until you actually have the experience of feeling as though you are all that was, all that ever will be, and all that is, that you can truly understand what it feels like to be as big as the whole gosh darn bloody universe. But that's not all. After realizing I'm all of existence, things can enter another final stage. This is what I like to call transversing to alternate dimensions. During this stage, it is quite similar to blasting off via DMT. In fact, I'm pretty much convinced that high enough doses of LSD are exactly the same as blast-off DMT trips, because I can meet the same entities. Now, after you've realized that, you know, it's no big deal, I'm just everything, I'm an immortal god, and you're just completely delusional bonkers, once this happens, you can full-on leave this universe and meet new universes. Unfortunately, or fortunately, I am unable to properly depict what this experience is like because, quite literally, it is ineffable. Basically, like I said, enough LSD with the correct setting can be just like blasting off via DMT. But I really do need to hammer this home and make it clear. The correct mindset is absolutely important for this to take place. I know people who can take 20 strips of acid and they will never lose consciousness. Then there's other individuals who just off 2 tabs will be completely blasted out of this universe. Only individuals which have a certain sense of understanding prior to journeying into their consciousness will reach these final levels. Kind of sounds like I'm talking about a video game, doesn't it? Only the most enlightened beings will reach the final level of the... But yeah, that's what LSD feels like. If you have never tried LSD, or you've just not gone as deep as what I'm explaining here, or you just simply can't relate to anything I'm talking about, I will probably look like an absolute lunatic to you. I should also mention that I am filming this video on April 19th, which is Bicycle Day. This video is a tribute to Bicycle Day. No, I am not taking LSD on Bicycle Day. I am completely sober, as you should be able to tell by my pupils. I'm just acting like a lunatic because... Wait, am I acting like a lunatic, or am I actually a lunatic? Or is there a difference between acting and being? But regardless, if you don't understand half of what I said, I can actually relate to you. Being completely sober right now, I can't even understand half of what I said. It's kind of like what I said at the start of the video. You have to be in that state to fully be able to relate and to understand it. And just because I have a past experience or past experiences of being in that state, it doesn't necessarily mean that now that I'm sober, I can just remember what it's like and then I'll be back there. If that was the case, then no one would ever have to trip more than once. People keep tripping because they want to recall what they've forgotten. They want to get back to that state. Kind of what the goal is, at least for me, has been to try to bring myself in my life to a point where I'm kind of in between being in that state all the time and in between being in the sober state. What I wanted to do was deprogram my mind and shed a lot of the negative conditioning that I've grown up learning and enter into more of a, you know, just like a zen state, man. I want to be more zen. Anyway, I hope you guys have fully enjoyed this video. If you have enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like, and if you haven't already, subscribe to our channel for more psychedelic-related content. A massive thank you to everyone who is supporting us on Patreon right now. It is thanks to your continued support that I'm able to continue to be crazy and make these outlandish videos for you guys. I hope all you guys had a really good bicycle day. I'm doing the sober thing right now, so I have not been able to do anything for Bicycle Day other than make this video, which was actually a pleasure to make. I'd rather create content like this than just lose my mind entering states that I've already been several times before that I'm getting a lot better at accessing without the need of substances, which is kind of the end goal here. I will be making more videos on my second channel about how to access these states without necessarily needing substances. I've already made a video that I'm sure a lot of you have already seen called Satori versus meditation, but if you haven't, then be sure to check that video out because it sheds some light on some of the things that I'm talking about here. Anyway, take care everyone and be safe.